Away from that story now, the Muslim community worldwide marked the celebration of the Eid Fitr over the weekend for most of them after the observance of the holy month of Ramadan. Eid Fitr means festival or breaking fast and marks the end of the fasting month of Ramadan. Sadly, these are troubled times for the whole world with COVID-19 pandemic ravaging the world. The world is battling with the pandemic to curtail the spread, but in any case, the celebration still has to go on. And joining me to discuss this Salah celebration with a difference is Imam Rewan Jamiu. Good afternoon, Jamiu.
Yes.
What's the significance of Salah in this holy season?
Alhamdulillah, salatu wasalam ala Rasulillah. Salah is a term that is common among the Hausa to describe the Eid. The proper Arabic word for this festival after fasting the month of Ramadan is Eid. The importance of Eid is to mark a great achievement in the life of a Muslim, having sacrificed their desires for the desire of their Lord God, Allah, the Creator and Sustainer. They abstain from eating and drinking and sexual relations for the sake of God Almighty from morning till evening for 30 days. So in worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they did that to demonstrate that they truly love Allah, they'll believe in Him, and they believe that everything He has instructed them to do would be beneficial to them in this world as well as in the hereafter. So to mark the end of this month of great month, the Muslims celebrate by offering 2 units of salat, 2 units of prayer, in the morning of the first day of the month that follows that of Ramadan. It's a joyous day. It's a day of happiness. It's a day of giving. It's a day of charity. It's a day of thanksgiving. And it's a day of love. That's the significance of the Salah for the Muslims.
All right. You would agree that this is a Salah that is different considering the restrictions that COVID-19 has imposed. I mean, government has imposed on the people because of COVID-19. How easy was it for, you know, your congregants to accept to celebrate Salah without having to congregate in the mosque and pray together?
Islam is rigid in principles, but flexible in application. Allah has made things easy for us. We should always accept whatever happens in our life. And any situation that we cannot change, we have been taught to learn to manage. If you want happiness in life and satisfaction, anything you know you can't change, just learn how to manage it. This, what is happening in the world, is beyond the control of any human. We have all seen how helpless we are. So we have to accept what God has decreed for us at this moment. So according to the government, they've seen that the best way to curtail the spread of the transmission of this disease is social distancing. And Muslims, as well as others, have been observing this. It doesn't stop them from worshiping Allah through salat, that is the formal prayer, but they don't congregate in the masjid. So not congregating in the masjid does not mean that they can't pray at home. We only pray at the masjid in order to foster love and solidarity among believers. If that is not possible and the government has placed a ban on gathering and we must be law-abiding, every Muslim is now expected to celebrate and observe the prayers and the Eid with their families or individually.
All right.
So we accept what God has decreed for this moment, and we believe that things will be better very soon, inshallah.
All right. Imam Jamiu, before we let you go, what message should Muslims and other Nigerians, of course, bear in mind at this time?
The message we should bear in mind is that we have all seen how helpless humans are, and we should believe in God Almighty. He has sent only one virus. Just one virus to the world, and everybody is in panic. And we are in fear. That is God. If God decides to fight us, then what? We are so helpless. We should always be God conscious, and we should be godly in every activities of ours. And secondly, since we know that the pandemic has left much loss economically amongst people, this is the time for us to come together as the one nation. We should help one another. Those who have, they should help the have not. This is the time for the rich to give back to the society from which they made their riches. And we thank God, many people have been doing that, but we need to sustain this generosity and charity, especially in the areas of empowerment of people who will likely lose their jobs or have already lost their jobs, and also those who are under pay cuts. And we need to support one another in all humanitarian ways we think we should be able to, and we should move closer to God. Mm-hmm. We should move closer to God because we know that everything is under His control.
That's
we
right.
pray to God, Allah, to remove this pandemic from the world and safeguard us all.
Amen. Thank you so very much, Imam Jamil. And once again, Eid Mubarak.
Thank you, Eid Mubarak. May Allah bless you all.
Amen.